Well, hello there. How are you today? I am doing very bare bones makeup today. This is more about sunscreen than makeup, and I just thought I would enjoy some tea and catch up with you and put on a little makeup. That was not much of an intro, was it? I'm out of practice. Okay, alrighty then. We have a sponsor for today's video, looseleafteamarket.com. I will drop that information down below. If you are a tea drinker, you know there is nothing better than organic loose leaf teas. You get so much more flavor than anything you get out of a tea bag, and you're actually getting healthful benefits for your body. And there are a lot of different types of teas out there, a lot of different ways you can get antioxidants. I discovered Loose Leaf Tea Market when I lived in Phoenix, and it's rather important to keep yourself hydrated when you live in the desert, and sometimes you get bored just drinking water, so I like drinking tea. In the summertime, I will drink it iced a lot, and in the winter, I drink it hot. So today, I am having Happy Place tea because I'm feeling like I'm getting back to my happy place, and I just want to tell you a little bit about what's going on in my world as I slap on some makeup and enjoy my tea, and let's catch up, shall we? So what's in this tea? It's got ginger, crystallized ginger. You can really taste the ginger in it. It's got some green tea, even though it is zero caffeine. Lemongrass, lemon verbena, chamomile, calendula, turmeric. It's got essential oils of sweet orange and lemon. It is, like I said, zero caffeine. It's supposed to be great for indigestion. It's great for reducing inflammation, which most of us have some inflammation going on somewhere. I always have arthritis in my hips going on, so I like to fight inflammation that way. And it relieves stress, because we all have stress in our lives, as much as we try to live stress-free lives. Okay, I picked this up a few weeks ago to use sort of as a sunscreen, something between a sunscreen and a makeup. It is Neutrogena Healthy Skin Anti-Aging Perfector in Fair to Light. And it has an SPF 20, and I have to tell you that I don't love it. I don't feel that it gives me quite enough coverage. I prefer my Elf BB cream. I get a little bit more coverage out of that. It feels very much like I'm putting a sunscreen on my face, but that is what I care about today, having a sunscreen on my face, so that's what we're going for. Yeah, it's very wet, like a sunscreen. So you can see, really no coverage at all. Little bit of a tint, but I have used a lot of other products that I think do a better job than this, but you know, I paid for it. I might as well use it, right? I'm gonna use a little Amazing Cosmetics. I'm really embarrassed to hold everything up anymore. Some of the stuff I'm using has been used for a lot of years and it's not in the best shape. So this is Amazing Cosmetics Concealer in Medium Beige. I have a few different shades of the Amazing Cosmetics Concealer. I use them at different times with different things and I'm not entirely sure why I use what when, but this was the one I grabbed today. The light golden tends to be something I only use in the wintertime when I use my palest base. The medium beige and the medium golden, I like the rest of the year. And it really just depends on which one I grab. I know you're probably tired of me doing real life makeup and you want to see me do glamorous makeup, especially after the last time I did glamorous makeup and it was such a disaster. I am going to be doing a photo shoot soon here in my apartment. And let me back up and tell you a little bit about why. This is my Joe Blasco Orange Highlight 1. Really a little heavy for today, but I grabbed it, so what the heck. So the last couple of videos that I did, you may have noticed that at the end of it, instead of saying uniquemonique.com, it said coming soon, sparklily.com. And I am creating a new website. It is sort of an online magazine, sort of a blog, sort of, I'm not really sure what. I'm still feeling my way around. When I started doing YouTube videos, I had my acting website, uniquemonique.com, and so I just sort of like put that on the end because that's where there was information about me. And a couple of times I put up little blog posts sort of about the things I was doing in the videos, but I always felt a little weird about doing too much beauty blogging on there because it was an acting website and it had been a site for fans of my acting since, oh gosh, 94, 95, whenever I first started it. So a long, long time, and it just always felt like it was, I don't know, disrespectful to the fans of the films to be like shoving beauty stuff down their throat if that wasn't necessarily their thing. So I was talking to a friend of mine, I used to date in Arizona, and we have maintained a wonderful friendship. I adore him. And he was saying, he helps me with my website, and he was saying, well, you should start doing this. And I said, well, I don't feel like it's right. And he's like, well, how about we build a new one for you? And I went, you know, yeah, but I don't want to do it alone. I don't want my voice to be the only voice on it. So I put feelers out to some of the amazing women that I have in my life. This is the e.l.f. High Def powder. I have amazing women friends. I have amazing men friends too, but I have some really wonderful women in my life, and I wanted to hear from them, and I wanted to include their voices. And because I can only tell my story, I can't tell everybody's story, and I wanted other people's stories, and I want it to just be this wonderful, positive place for women over 40. And I'm still developing it, it's still growing. I'm in the process of writing a bunch of articles for it. My friends are writing. We are doing a photo shoot in a couple of days here, so I'll be doing makeup for that, or I may even be hiring a makeup artist to do makeup for that. Since we've seen how well I work under pressure lately. Yeah, I really don't like that foundation, but it's fine. Today is running errands. Oh, habit. I had gotten this Wet n Wild blush that I was gonna put on, but you're supposed to do that before you powder, not after you powder. And I forgot. So, rather than use it wrong, I guess we'll just wait and use this another time. So that is what I am doing. I am creating this website, which will be just an extension of what I do in these videos, all the same things. I'm gonna talk a lot about the products that I use on my hair. It's going to be I'm very excited about it. I don't even have all the words right now. So I'm very much in my happy place, creating that. My eyebrow is Anastasia Brow Wiz in granite. Not that end. That end. Working on this TV show, been super fun, having a great time doing it. Can't tell you anything about it yet. Not permitted to put anything up on social media about it yet. As soon as I can say anything and share things with you, you know I will. But know that I worked on it last week, I worked on it this week. I'm dark for a couple of weeks on it, which is great because I've got a whole bunch of other stuff going on. May have to actually pluck this eyebrow soon. I haven't plucked my eyebrows in years. I forget how. But this eyebrow is starting to actually get a little full. I'm gonna get some more Happy Place tea. I will be right back. So for my blush, I'm gonna use my Urban Decay Naked's Flushed. Ah, that looks very bright on my cheek. Oh, that's better. On a sadder note, a week ago I split up with the man that I've been seeing, Michael. Not that he did anything wrong. He is a wonderful, fabulous man, and we just met each other at the wrong time in our lives. And that's just, I think, what it boils down to. He's got a lot of stuff happening in his world. Has nothing to do with me. Bunch of stuff happening, and it's sort of like a downer, and I think I've shared that with you before. I have a lot of stuff happening in my life that's incredibly positive. I have wonderful, exciting things going on in my life, and I just found that I would be up on this level, and then I'd go see him, and I'd come back down to this level. And then I'd have to drag myself back up. And every time I'd try to swing myself back up, it was getting to be less and less and less. And I just realized that as much as I care about this person and as much as I think he's an awesome guy, I have to let him follow his own path and learn his own lessons and do what he needs to do before we can be good for one another. Does that make sense? I mean, I don't want to, like, go blabbing other people's business all around. It's private. But, gosh, that makes it sound like it's so much more than it is. It's not. It's just poor timing. And oddly enough, I ran into him on Easter Sunday. I was walking to a friend's house to take care of her cats, and he drove past me, and he pulled over, and we talked for a little while, and maybe another time, but not right now. And that's just how it is, because I need to stay in my happy place. And sometimes you have to be selfish, as hard as that is. So, happy place. Do I even want eyeshadow today? Do I even care about eyeshadow day? I don't really. I mean, yeah, it's terrible. I like me without makeup. I don't care about wearing makeup for the most part. I really don't wear makeup if I don't have to. Let's go into my Smashbox palette, my Smashbox Smoky palette. And I'm just going to take a flat brush and I'm just going to take some of this dark matte gray, just a dark matte gray on a flat brush, and I'm just going to tap this at the base of my lashes. Just for a little subtle definition. That made it a little smudgier than this side. Less subtle, more defined. So be it. That's really all I want. Yeah, my hair's not very exciting today. Well, maybe not for you, but I put it in a ponytail, and that's pretty darn exciting for me. It's not much of a ponytail, I know, but I'm excited. I used to be able to put it in a ponytail a while ago, and then I got my hair cut, and it was cut, you know, she cut it up shorter here on the nape, so I couldn't put it up, and it's just nice now that it's going up. Oh, by the way, I've been taking a supplement for hair, Nutrafol, I should have to get the bottle, I forget what it's called. Yes, I've been using this, and I don't know if that's why my eyebrows are suddenly growing in more, but I've been using this for about 6 weeks now. And Nutrafol, let's see what it has in it. It's got vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, biotin, zinc, marine collagen type 1 and 2. It's got a whole bunch of stuff in it. You know, it's, you like to feel that you're trying everything you can. And so you know how I am with my hair. I'm trying to get it to grow. I am determined for my hair to get to my shoulders, and it will eventually. And I'm hoping that adding supplements to my diet will help. I don't know, but we give it a shot. Try to get as much healthy stuff into the body as possible, right? Okay, mascara, this is the L'Oreal Voluminous Feline, just because it's handy. So I think that we will be launching Spark Lily. And first off, let me tell you about why I called it Spark Lily. I remember the first time that I heard a woman refer to her silver hairs as her sparkles. And I loved that because we always hear about, oh, I pulled another gray hair from my head. It's as though it's a negative. And by calling the gray hairs a sparkle, I thought that was such a wonderful way to turn what society has told us is a negative and make it into a positive. By the way, one of the shows that I like to watch on TV is New Girl, and a couple of the shots recently have been out in full sun, and Zoe Deschanel, who is just so talented and so adorable, and she has maybe 5 or 7 little silver strands that run through her hair, and Thank you for rocking them, for sporting them. Every time I watch the show and I see those few little silver sparkles, I'm like, yes, thank you for representing. So that's how I feel about sparkles. And I wanted to name the new website something about sparkles, but of course, everything sparkle is taken. I was kind of playing sparkle, sparkle, sparkly, sparklily, spark, oh, spark lily. And I kind of like spark lily, because it sounds like saying sparkly after you've said it too many times or had a little bit of champagne. It's just kind of fun to say. Spark lily. It's not just sparkly, it's spark lily. So, sparklily is about celebrating not just our silver hairs, but celebrating that which sets us apart, that which makes us unique. For some of us, it is our hair color. For others of it is anything else, anything that sets you apart, anything that you feel makes you different from other people, that's your sparkle. That is your sparkle, that which makes you unique. So, in that way, I feel that sparklily relates in a way to uniquemonique.com. They're both about celebrating your own individuality, and that is what sparklily is all about. I started to say something else and I completely forgot what it was. I got a lot on my plate right now. I mean, it's awesome, but I got a lot on my plate right now. Oh, I was going to tell you. I was going to tell you, we think we're going to be launching sparklily sometime in early May. I am busy writing articles. I'm writing every day. My girlfriends, who are going to be my staff writers, are writing every day. We are putting together a bunch of content so that when we launch, it is interesting and entertaining for you. My goal in the future is to have it be a place where anybody can write their story and we can help inspire each other through writing our own stories and sharing our own stories. So it will have my professional staff, but I eventually want to incorporate others. First things first. So don't ask me about that yet. I got no information there. My bandwidth only holds so much. But it's coming. My lips have been a little dry lately, so I'm going to use the Mineral Fusion lip butter. And I cannot see what the color is because I am blind, as you know, but I will look it up and I will drop it down below in the video description box. One of the nice things that I do intend to have on Sparklily. See, I'm still learning to say it. Is I want to have like one great place where you can source everything out. So if you see something, you're, oh yeah, that's where you can find it. When people say, "Hey, the mirror that you use, where did you get it?" I can have that there. When you know people say, "Hey, what's that shiny thing behind you?" It's an acrylic plastic chandelier that I got for like $70 10 years ago, and it just has a little light bulb in it and it just hangs from it. And I just think it's the coolest thing. And it's a little tacky, and I kind of like things a little tacky, and I like things very sparkly. See what I did there? So, all my sparkly things. I'm just enjoying what somebody in the parking lot is choosing to share with us about their lives. Sorry, I don't know if you could hear any of that. I think that kind of brings us up to speed. I told you about Sparklily. I told you about working on the movie or the TV show. I told you about the breakup, and we got to listen to the phone ring in the parking lot because people apparently like to have their conversations on speakerphones in the cars so that everyone can hear them. That's fun. I just wish they'd say more scandalous things so it was more entertaining. That's it. That's what I got for you today. I will be doing a photo shoot for Sparklily in a couple of days, and I'm going to bring you along on that. It should be a lot of fun. You met my friend Amanda before. Amanda will be photographing me, and so we're not only going to have a photo shoot, we're going to have a really fun girls' day. that is also a good way to find your happy place. Spend time with good friends. And I love you bunches. I hope you have an awesome rest of your day. Please subscribe to my videos if you haven't already. And coming soon is sparklily.com, and I'm super excited. And find your happy place.